if you think about it, the whole rise of suburbia was accompanied with this idea of individual initiative, individual freedom, the apotheosis, or whatever that word is, of the American way. And in fact, the growth of the suburbs was hugely subsidized by the federal government, even while people were talking about an end to the public and end to statism and collectivism and things like that, you know. But, and of course, the point is a vast resource went there, where in fact the public housing, which was ridiculed as a place of welfare and stuff, much less funds went to. But I want to talk about in the period in the 80s, 90s, there was one place where there was a vast construction of housing for poor people. And that's the prison system, where from roughly 1980 till today, it went from like 800,000 to 2.45 million people in prison. And what's the relation between that growth on one hand, globalization, the draining of millions of jobs from the inner city, the massive growth of prison and criminalization of particularly black and Latino and other youth of color, and at the same time then the destruction of not just public housing, but also the end of welfare as we know it, as Bill Clinton called it, and that kind of thing.
On the last point, great point about the relationship between, of course, the historical policy and the construction of the suburbs, but the contemporary policy around the construction of prison and what many social scientists call the prison industrial complex, which is related to, somebody asked about the relationship between private capital and the federal government around urban development. The relationship between private capital and the federal government and state governments around the construction of prisons and the labor of prisoners is a story that we have lots of information on, and it's important to keep ourselves well aware of. The one thing I will say is some of the research around unemployment. So here in the U.S., we like to compare ourselves to Western Europe and say, yeah, well, Western Europe has a much bigger safety net, a much bigger welfare state, meaning they have better unemployment benefits and child care and family leave and all those kinds of things, but they can only do it because they cripple their private sector and they have a much higher unemployment rate. Well, if Bruce Western and his colleagues have studied the unemployment rate here in the U.S. and how it is artificially underestimated because of the millions of people that we incarcerate. We have the highest incarceration rate of any industrialized country, and what we do when we incarcerate what is often called surplus labor is we artificially lower our unemployment rate. And so we make ourselves supposedly look better vis-a-vis Western Europe, but of course we don't look any better with that astronomical incarceration rate.